Psalm 128 verse 1. We are reading from Psalm 128. There are 6 verses. And we are going to have an expository message from Psalm 128. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways. Blessed is everyone. The Hebrew word there means enviably happy. He is enviably happy. Blessed is everyone. Is not everyone, anyone, whosoever he may be, whether educated or not educated, whether rich or poor, man or woman. Blessed is everyone, or anyone that may be. Blessed is anyone that feareth the Lord, that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways, that walketh in his ways. Now verse 4, he tells the congregation, it's a song of degrees, it's a song of ascent. As they were climbing the mountain to go to Zion, Jerusalem, they'll be singing all these songs. These songs are called the songs of ascent, as they are going up, as they are going up, they are to sing these songs. So now the psalmist says, behold, look, see, behold, that thus shall the man, or here we can say woman, or any person, thus shall the man be blessed that feareth the Lord. He says how a man will be blessed in this way, in this fashion. See, behold, consider, thus shall the man be blessed that feareth the Lord. I'm going to speak to you on 3 captions, 3 subtitles. Number 1, thus blessed. In this way, they are blessed. Thus blessed. Number 2, fear of the Lord. Fear of the Lord. Thus blessed that fear the Lord. That fear the Lord. Number 3, walking in his ways, in God's ways. Walking in God's ways. Thus blessed that walk in God's ways. So in every point, thus blessed, I'm going to show you from this psalm in 5 ways how they are blessed. Fear of the Lord. I'm going to share with you 5 points what really is the fear of the Lord. What does the scripture mean by fear of the Lord? And also I'm going to share with you 5 points. What do you mean by walking in his ways? What do you mean by walking in his ways? So all together I'm going to share with you 15 salient points. I don't say they are complete, but certainly they are concise. Number 1, thus blessed. Thus blessed. In this way they shall be blessed. 5 points. Number 1, verse 2. You can make a note of these points for your further meditation. For thou shalt eat the labor of thine hands, happy shalt thou be, and it shall be well with thee. Number 1, financial blessing. The Lord loves to bless us financially. My dear brother, my dear sister, till this day, I can say, we lack no good thing. The Lord satisfies His people with His goodness. The Lord desires the prosperity of His servants. I always say this in the life of Jesus. In 2 places Jesus was laid down. In the manger, in swaddling clothes, He was laid down when He was born. When Jesus died, He was laid down in a rich man's sepulcher with all perfume, and His body was shrouded with fine linen, with fine linen. When Mother Mary was feeding Him in the manger, when He was suckling His first milk from the breast of His earthly mother, it was in a manger where the cattle fodder will be there. But the Last Supper, the first suck was in the manger. The Last Supper was in an upper room, well furnished. So even in an earthly sense, the beginning of your life on the, your spiritual life, you see poverty, etc., etc. But when you end your spiritual life, or when you breathe last in the earth, you will be dying as the king. You will be dying as the king. That's the spiritual truth. My dear brother, my dear sister, the blessings of the Lord makes one rich. When the Lord blesses you, the Lord makes you rich. And also the Bible says, He gives us the strength, the wisdom, the knowledge, the skill. He gives us the strength to become rich. He blesses the work of our hands. My dear brother, my dear sister, we read in the Bible, Paul says, God became poor that through His poverty we could become rich. Some people misinterpret that and say, God became spiritually poor. God became poor that we could become spiritually rich. It's a wrong interpretation. God became poor that we could become rich. If that is only to become rich spiritually, then He must have become poor spiritually. He didn't become poor spiritually. He was rich spiritually. He was born in a manger. There was no place for Him to lay His head. He was just a roaming creature. He didn't buy lands. He didn't have cattle, camels. He possessed nothing in this world. He became poor that we could become rich. That we could become rich. My dear brother, my dear sister, what you reap, what you sow, you reap. They that sow money, they reap money. When you are true to God with all your substance, the Lord opens the windows of heaven and blesses you in a way that you shall have no room to receive it. I can go on and on. Here the first thing the Lord says, I will bless you spiritually, for thou shalt eat the labor of thine hands. Happy shalt thou be, and it shall be well with thee. Your labor, it shall be, what shall be? Your labor shall be well with thee. You lack no good thing. Number two, thus blessed. It is not only the Lord blesses you financially, the Lord blesses our family lives. Our family lives. Thy wife shall be a fruitful vine by the side of thine house. Thy children like olive plants round about thy table. So here we see husband, wife, parents, children. The Lord brings a family unit, a family unit. In Christian marriage, they exchange a troth. A troth means a vow. They exchange the marriage troth. In that they say that I love you in all seasons, till death put us asunder. Till death could separate somebody from the family. There should be no separation. In every family, in one way or the other, death is inevitable. Every family has seen death in one way or the other. Your father has died, your mother has died, husband or wife or a child, a brother, sister. Somebody has died in every family. Last year, the same week, in one week, I lost my dear brother and my dear sister in one week time. One Friday my brother, next Friday my sister. It was an irreparable loss. Both were sudden death. Both were heart attacks or heart failures. Sudden death. It's very painful. I understand the pain of somebody passes away. But other than death, nothing should separate the family. No quarrel, no bitterness because he's a drunkard, no fight. She went to her mother's place, he went to her somewhere. Committing suicide, they don't want to live together. Children don't want to be in the house. Children want to run away. So what should be real pain? Not the death. Death will come, it's inevitable. In so many different ways death will come. In a very short duration, our dear sister, she lost her father and subsequently her mother. Brother and sister were left alone. So I'm not talking about that separation. Other than that, the family must be a united one. When we fear the Lord and walk in His ways, the husband, wife, parents, children, brother, sister, they all will be united. Brother and sister, they will not fight at all. They may not know how to fight. Akka is 3 years old, Thambi is 2 years old, Thangachi is 2 years old. These two fight. Parents didn't know whom to beat. Finally, they beat on their own head. Two-year-old child fights. For everything they fight. Because the blessing of the Lord is not resting. The Lord wants to bless us. I know in family, they have a boy and a girl. And suddenly I'll say, I don't remember a single day Anna and Tangachi fought for a toy or fought for a chocolate or fought for anything. Not a single day. This is the blessing of the Lord. Death may put us asunder, we cannot avoid it. Certain things are untimely. But apart from that, the family must be united. Here it says, the wife shall be as a fruitful vine by the sides of thine house. God willing, I'll give an exposition of this song word by one sometime later. It's a very powerful song. The Lord blesses the labor of the husband, and the wife as a fruitful vine. She is also a fruit-bearing vine. But she takes care of the house by the sides of thine house. She was also a contributor. She is also a contributor to the family income by the sides of her house. I was wondering what type of work she was doing. By the sides of her house, she was looking after her children. Probably she had a small farm, chicken. And she was rearing chicken. Probably they had a cow. She was rearing a cow. What were three cows? What else? By the sides of the house. Probably she had a kitchen garden. She had a kitchen garden. Somewhere she was able to contribute to the family needs. Probably she was spinning some clothes and selling. Today, probably she was doing tailoring. After our marriage, I didn't want sister to go to work. I'm not saying going to work is right or wrong, but I didn't want sister to go to work. A very big business magnate, one of the richest business magnates at that time in India. Their sons were my students. Their husband and wife, they loved us their own children. And after a sister's profile, he one day just did like this and said, "Miss Simon, you say yes, I'll get your wife a job and see that she earns more than you." He said, "I'm sorry." Then from one company a job opportunity came. They phoned me and said, "Please send sister, it's a ministry oriented job." I said, "No, I don't want." So we decided to give this opportunity to a daughter of one of my earlier colleagues. So she was a widow. So we gave the job opportunity to that girl. In the same job, now she is in the States. Not to brag about. But sister was not sitting idle in the house. She was taking tuitions. She was a contributory, financially she was contributory member. So 1 hour, every evening, she was taking math tuition, general tuition. So here we read, the husband was, the Lord was blessing his, the work of his hand. His wife also in one way industrial. I don't say that every wife should be earning money, but you must be able to contribute wine to the house. You must be able to contribute joy to the house. You must be able to contribute satisfaction to the house. That wife, the wife of one that fears God, not the one that fears wife. It is the wife of one that fears God. There are three men in a bar. They were sharing their experience in their house. One man said, "She, my wife made me stand out and she was hitting me. Gave nice blows, making me stand out and hit me. In a terrible utashtada." The other man said, "My wife is better, she made me come in. But made me kneel down and beat me and a malangal podochashtada." The third man was just, nothing like that in our house. Who has insulted you at least? No. I made her kneel down. Huh? How did? I made my wife kneel down, the third drunkard said. How was that possible? It's simple. I went underneath the cart. She knelt down and beat me. Na kattle kattle paitanda, av mutti potta nadchada. It's not the fear of the wife. My dear brother, my dear sister. And the children, they are sitting around the table. So it's not whether a member died or not died. Among the living there should be a lively fellowship. Husband, wife, children, akka, anna, tambi, tangachi. That's the real joy of a family. Where's the boy gone? Nobody knows. The boy is doing, they're playing some games. His cook kept on the table. Mother is gone to watch the TV. Naiki kuda selavatla kooptu saapadu poduvaanga. Engada irukku saapadu engamma table la irukku eduthuko. Table la irukku nannalum paravaala aduppula irukku eduthukomma. Emma saapadu enga irukku aduppula irukku eduthukora. Shatti lalik eduthukoda. There is no pandi. On the other side, certainly we can't experience this in a drunkard's house. He will be fully drunk, lying down somewhere and eating some masala vada, some kara vada. And he will be lying down somewhere. The wife would have gone to mother's place. The child will be in Aya's house. There will be no pandi. There will be no proper income. They don't have enough income for the tasmak. It is a curse. It's a curse in that family. There is no proper food. They are unable to sit together. They are unable to say the grace together. They are unable to eat together. It is a curse. This day take a decision that you will fear the Lord. This day take a decision, you fear the Lord. In your family there shall be peace. Till death takes away a person, you'll be living in love, you'll be living in peace. My dear brother, my dear sister, God shall ordain that peace in the family. So here the promise is, financially He blesses us and family He blesses. Number 3, we read in verse 5, the Lord shall bless thee out of Zion, and thou shalt see the goodness of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. All the days of thy life thou shalt see the goodness of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. The third blessing is a spiritual blessing. Is a spiritual blessing. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion. That is holy abode. From Zion, the Lord shall bless thee out of Zion. What shall come out of Zion? What shall come out of Zion? In the book of Isaiah and the book of Micah, we read, from Zion His law proceeds. Is the totality of the Bible, the totality of the Word of God. The totality of the Word of God is the mind of God. The totality of the Word of God is the mind of God. So in Zion, the mind of God proceeds. The mind of God comes to you from Zion. So He blesses you with a good church, with a good fellowship. My dear brother, my dear sister, you please understand the spiritual truth. The Lord delivers you, one from a family, two from a tribe, and brings you to Zion. And God gives you shepherds according to His own heart, and they will lead you with wisdom and prudence. They will lead you with wisdom and prudence. The Lord will not bring anybody to any organization. Organization is a non-living entity. Whether it is ACA or CCA or DCA or DCA, with all alphabets we can play. Or we can say CPM, TPM, which is right, CPM right or TPM right. Not these alphabets. All organizations are non-living beings. And the statement of faith of every organization speaks about the identity of the organization. The statement of faith. I believe that Jesus will come for the church. We call the rapture of the church. Then there shall be the tribulation when the wrath of God will be poured on the face of the earth. This is what I believe. This is the statement of faith of this organization. In another organization, they may not believe there's a rapture. They may believe the church has to go through tribulation. That's their faith. That is their faith. But the person, the shepherd, the pastor, the presbyter, the elder, the padre, whatever the name by which you could call him, he leads you with wisdom and prudence. When He brings you to Zion, He gives you a shepherd according to His heart. So he brings you to a place where that shepherd, emotionally, spiritually, physically, mentally, intellectually, in every possible way, he leads you with wisdom and prudence. The other day they were telling me about one pastor. He says, any worldliness is not wrong. Everything God has given, enjoy. The Lord hasn't taken you there. Now I'm not sitting on a judgment to say they are right or wrong, but the Lord has brought you here. The Lord has brought you here. And this is the teaching the Lord wants me to give you. He puts that in my heart. So with that love and affection, I share that with you. My dear brother, my dear sister, sometimes you may like it, sometimes you may not like it. But the Lord has brought you here with a purpose. So from Zion, what will proceed? The word of God will, the law of God will proceed from Zion, the totality of the Bible. So you can be happy the Lord has brought you to a church where no compromise is made. Yesterday one servant of God was talking to me, and he told me about another servant of God, said that pastor really wept. That pastor really wept, saying, I am unable to preach all these things in the church. I am unable to preach all these things in the church. Why? Why should he be hesitant? What seems to be right, I tell you. What seems to be wrong, I tell you. I got the responsibility of preparing a people ready for the Lord. I got the responsibility. From Jerusalem, Zion, the Lord shall come. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion. From sound doctrine, when you fear the Lord, the Lord shall surely take you to a place where there is a sound doctrine. When you don't fear the Lord may not take you to a place where there is a sound doctrine. So the blessings of them that fear the Lord is a blessing financially, it's a blessing in a family way, blessing in a spiritual way. My dear brother, my dear sister, when I got saved, the Lord led me to Sister Sarah Navaraj. Only in preaching I say Sister Sarah Navaraj. Otherwise when I say sister, that is Sister Sarah Navaraj. Even in our family conversation, sister part. Sister Sannanga, even I dread to say their names. And the Lord took me to Pastor Sundara, strong in word of God. And my love with Sister Sarah Navaraj continued. My honor, my respect, in one word if I say, Sister Sarah Navaraj, Amma told somebody, and they are talking about me, he said, Avar yen paiyan la, Avar yen paiyan la. My dear brother, my dear sister, I was able to maintain that relationship. And before I could start this ministry, the Lord was keeping me under Sundaram and Sam Sundaram, and I was translator for both of them. I don't know how much I love them. And the world knows, and many of our close associates know, how much both of them loved me. And the greatest testimonial I ever heard, when Pastor Sam Sundaram was very sick, he told Pastor Colley, Caleb, don't misunderstand. He mentioned a few names and said, above all, the first place in my heart, the first place in my heart is Robert Simon. My dear brother, my dear sister, I'm going to tell you a very important spiritual truth. We read in this verse, the Lord shall bless thee out of Zion. The Lord always kept me in good posture. He has given me good shepherds. I know only four people, their preachings are five. Sister Sarah Navaraji, Pastor Lazarus of Mathura, a great saint, he baptized me. Till the last day he loved me. Messages of Pastor Sundaram, Sam Sundaramaya. Nobody else. And today if I talk, they say, Robert, good Bible scholar, Veda Pandita, this and it's all nothing, it's all what I suck from the breast of the saints. It's all what I suck from the breast of these saints. I am proud of them. And earnestly I believe, till their death, they were proud of me. So the Lord shall bless thee out of Zion. There's a good word of God, the totality of the word of God. And thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of your life. Thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of your life. My dear brother, my dear sister, I told you I'm going to tell you something very, very important in this. I want to teach you 15 points. I don't know whether I will be able to finish even the first 5 points. What are the blessings we get when we fear the Lord? All our life, we should see the good of Jerusalem. Whatever the church, Jerusalem speaks about a local church. Whatever the local church, the Lord keeps us. We should see the good of that church. It has got two parts. We must be a contributory member to that church. We must see the good of that church. You must see to it. You have to pray for that church. You have to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And through the grace God has given you, you should be a contributory member to that church, to all your life. To all your life. And I tell you very lovingly, Jerusalem is a beautiful for situation, for habitation, but it has got many minus points. There's no good water resource, there's no mineral value, no sea by the side, no river. It's not a very fertile place. Only the dew from Zion would be able to wet that Jerusalem. You cannot find on the earth a perfect local church. A perfect local church. Anna Jivanandam, he used to present the truth in a very light, jovial manner. Now Eleazar brought 10 camels to take Rebekah to Isaac. So Rebekah is Jesus. I'm sorry, Isaac is Jesus. Rebekah, the church, and Eleazar, the Holy Spirit. The camel is a local church. Eleazar needs the camel to take Rebecca to Jesus, to Isaac. Holy Spirit needs a local church to take a believer to Jesus Christ. But there, Eliezer cannot find a camel without a camel's hunch. Every camel will have a hunch. If Rebecca wants to choose a camel without hunch, she cannot reach Isaac. She has to accept the camel Eliezer gives her. Eliezer gives her. My dear brother, my dear sister, you must know the church, the fellowship God gives you. There will be a lot of ups and downs. The Lord has kept me in different churches, two churches. I was with Sister Sara Navaraji, then I was with Pastor Sundaramayya. Now I started calling. How these changes came. But wherever the Lord kept us, I don't say everything was very comfortable. Very comfortable. There were ups and downs. Certain things we could not understand. Certain things we could not accept. Certain things we are not comfortable. One day I was called when I was with sister. She prayed for me. At that time a few Nigerians were coming there. She prayed for me and said, next Sunday you should translate for me. I was, it was a dreadful thing to stand before, by the side of the great servant of God and translate. At that time, I was very young also, maybe 22 or 23. That Sunday when I went there, and the sister was translating her, I was finding it very comfortable. It's good for her also. A lady, she is finding comfortable to have a lady translator. I was not hurt. In the presence of God, I tell, not even somewhere in the corner I was not hurt. My dear brother, my dear sister, with a very divine purpose, the Lord took me to Pastor Sundaram. On the pulpit when I was translating, I was a teacher at that time, one of the good type payers at that time. I was standing by his side and translating. In Tamil he was using a word, Anyer. Anyer. I said, sojourner. In the Bible, in that passage, for that word unear in English, it's given sojourner. Sojourner. I said, we are sojourners. He looked at me and said, unear. I said, we are sojourners. He stared at me and gave me a hit. I was married, I got a child. On the stage, my pastor hit me. On the stage my pastor hit me and said, enna unga language kaatirukinga nikkringala unga language kaatirukinga nikkringala. There was one incident. I can quote a number of incidents like this. We submitted. We loved them. We honored them. The buffeting of a righteous man is an oil on our head. Next day I went to his room. I showed it in the Bible. Pastor, this is the word in the Bible. Sojourner. போ எனக்கு தெரியாது தம்பி சாரி, நாளைக்கு நான் அடுத்த வாரம் நான் சேர்ச்சில் மன்னிப்பு கேட்குறேன் அடிச்சதுக்கு. இந்த நீங்கள் மன்னிப்பெல்லாம் கேட்க வேணா, தட் வில் மேக் இட் மோர் அக்லி, இன்னொரு மோசமாக தெரியும். வேணா விட்டுருங்க பாஸ்டர், பட் ஐ வாண்ட் டு ஷோ யூ இஸ் நாட் டு ஷோ மை லாங்குவேஜ், இட் இஸ் இன் த பைபிள். எனக்கு தெரியாது தம்பி, மன்னிச்சுக்கோங்க. My dear brother, my dear sister, so all your life you must see the good of Jerusalem. You must see the good of Jerusalem. There can be two or three things that can separate a person from a local church. Number one, the Lord leads you for a ministry or for a particular situation. With all your love and affection, if you know for certain the Lord leads you, you can leave that local church. Many years back, on my birthday, when I was on my knees, a brother phoned me and he said, I want to go to such and such church. I want to help that brother. I want to help that brother. I said, did you pray? Does God lead you? He openly said, I came to your church not because God led you. God led me. So he went to that church. Within a week, he had a fight with that pastor. So almost about to exchange blows. He left that church. He was ministering one church and helping another pastor for some time. There also he had problem. Went to another church in Mugape. He was there for a few weeks. He was not comfortable. Finally, he went to a place where there could be no return. There also he is not abiding by the rules. So one day when he met me, I told him, are you in the church because God led you? He said, no. I said, please, at least now you pray and see which is your church. Which is your church? So number one, the Lord can lead you because the Lord leads you out of a local church for the sake of a ministry. Number two, probably you are employed elsewhere where you cannot physically come to the local church. Allow you keep your relationship with the shepherd God has given you, your spiritual father, your spiritual mother, your spiritual fellowship. When you are in a work situation, you go to your church there, probably the knowledge of your pastor, for your spiritual feed. But have a love fellowship with the church. Physically you are unable to come. You are unable to come from state. You are unable to come from Abu Dhabi. You are unable to come from Dubai. You are unable to come from Malaysia every Sunday. Now many of our believers continue to have the fellowship even through this web streaming. They are listening to the messages. But they attend the church there. And they are also true there. And they continue to have fellowship with us also. And number three, when you know the doctrine of the church where you are attending is wrong, you talk to the pastor. As Martin Luther said, you go on your knees, believe that the pastor is right and you are wrong, but your understanding is different. You talk to him again and again, you talk to him again and again. If you are convinced that the pastor cannot be changed and he is going in the wrong direction, the wrong spirit, then you quit that church and go to a place where the Lord leads. The Lord will lead you. Otherwise, in all your life, see the good of that church. See the good of that church. My dear brother, my dear sister, there are people, those who change their jobs. Similarly, people are changing, switching from one church to the other, one church to the other today. Dr. Ravi Zacharias, in one of his messages, said this beautiful anecdote. There was a shipwreck and a sailor was ashore to a lonely island and he was stranded there. There was no other human being. So every day he used to wave his shirt to draw the attention of a aircraft or a ship, and nobody was able to notice this lonely man who was stranded in an island. One day somehow a helicopter that was flying low, they noticed him and they landed in that island, and he took the crew. He gave them some refreshment what was available in that island, and those crew, they saw three huts there. It was one hut where this man was living in. He had just erected one small hut. So one of the rescuers asked him, "What about the other hut?" "Yeah, that hut is the church where I am going. That hut is the church I am going." "Then what about the other third hut?" "Yeah, that was the church I was going. That was the church I was going." My dear brother, my dear sister, very lovingly I tell you, in all your life, see the good of Jerusalem. Don't run away from Jerusalem. When you are going from Jerusalem, running away from Jerusalem, you may be caught in the hands of the robbers. They will rob you of all grace you have got, all skill you have got. Somewhere they will leave you half dead. That's spiritual truth. Where the Lord has kept you, bear fruits there. You will be blessed. Your life will be a blessing. So spiritual blessing, the Lord shall bless you out of Zion with the totality of the word of God. And you shall see the good of Jerusalem in all your life. Jerusalem speaks about a local church. You pray for Jerusalem and God will bless you with all the goodness of Jerusalem. You shall see the good of Jerusalem. So my dear brother, my dear sister, here we see the Lord blesses us financially. The Lord blesses our family life. The Lord blesses our spiritual life. The Lord blesses our spiritual life. You cannot compare the teachings of elsewhere with this church. This is the church where the Lord has brought you this fellowship. Listen from here. God will judge you according to the teachings you hear in the church. Sabayin kelviyin padiye avarude nyayam theerpa. What that you are listening in this church, obey to that teaching. Obey to that teaching. And Paul writes when he was writing to Philippians, "You are partakers of the grace that is given unto us. நீங்கள் எங்களுக்கு அளித்த கிருபைக்கு பங்குள்ளவர்கள்." The grace that is given to sister, that grace given to me. You are partakers of that grace given to me. You are partakers of the grace that is given to sister. It is not the grace that is given to somebody else. It is not the grace that is given to somebody else. Not the grace that is given to Alan Parr or Alvin Thomas or somebody else. You are partakers of the grace that is given to Robert Simon and Sister Premi. I don't know why I am speaking all these things, but the Lord wants to tell you. Psalm 128 is a very powerful song. God wants to bless you when you fear the Lord and walk in His ways. So number one, you are blessed financially. Number two, you are blessed in a family, in your family life. Number three, you are blessed spiritually. Number four, verse 6. "Yea, thou shalt see thy children's children." My dear brother, my dear sister, literally, the Lord will satisfy you with longevity. the long life. There are different reasons how our life can be extended. My dear brother, my dear sister, when you respect your father and mother, when you fear the Lord and walk in His ways, your life will be extended. So what is the perfect age? We will die in perfect age. What is perfect age? 70? 80? 90? 100? 120? Can anybody tell me what is the perfect age? The Lord will satisfy you with the longevity of life. What is the perfect age? Can anybody tell me? 60? 70? What? 80? Nobody wants to specify that age. My dear brother, my dear sister, the perfect age, in a very simple way, when you know that you have accomplished the purpose for which God has called you. Jesus died when he was 33 approximately. It was not an untimely death. Jesus died in the right age, just 33. But when Jesus died on the cross, Jesus was able to say, "It's finished. It's finished." My dear brother, my dear sister, even in a worldly way, when we fear the Lord helps us see our children and the children of children. But physically, somebody may be a barren, or somebody may not have grandchildren. So it's not only physically, spiritually, the real longevity. When we are able to lead souls to the Lord, and the souls we lead, when they are leading others to the Lord. Yesterday when I was talking to a dear brother, I said, people, those who receive the Holy Spirit in my meeting, by the grace of God, they are international preachers. Many people I have baptized, they have become pastors and pastor monks. They have become VBS directors. So spiritually speaking, I see children and the children of children and their children also There was a pastor ordination in AOG, in AG Church. I was invited to that pastor ordination. One senior pastor from AOG, AG, he was conducting the service and he was to ordain that pastor, and his wife. And another AG pastor was to give the sermon. I went and sat with the audience. I was enjoying that service. When the time of ordination came, suddenly that senior pastor of AG Church, he called me, "Pastor Robert Simon, you come and ordain these people." I was broken and shed tears. You know the secret behind it? Thank God I got received the Holy Spirit in the early 70s. This pastor's wife was a small girl, she was our neighbor. I was conducting children ministry for children. In that child ministry she attended and she received the Holy Spirit in that meeting. She received Holy Spirit. She was must be at that time third standard or fourth standard, fifth standard maximum. She had received the Holy Spirit in that meeting. I came to Madras, I was teaching in St. George's, I was attending ACA, I was teaching in the VBS there. And this boy, that pastor, was my VBS student. And one of my VBS programs, he received the Holy Spirit. After many years, they got married. Both of them received the Holy Spirit in my meeting. And suddenly it so happened, I was to conduct the ordination service for both of them. I can give you number of illustrations like this. If you fear God and walk in His ways, you will see people getting saved through your ministry. And also your eyes shall see the people are getting saved through them who are saved through you. What a wonderful blessing it is. Those who are brought to the Lord through you, the Lord has used an instrument to bring somebody into the Lord, they will not become empty seats. They will become soul winners. They will become powerful evangelists. They will become pastors. They will become prophets. It is a spiritual blessing. The Lord will bless you and make you a blessing. You shall see the children of children. My dear brother, my dear sister, he that fears the Lord and walks in His ways, he that fears the Lord and walk in His ways, thus shall he be blessed. He will be enviably happy. Financially he lacks no good thing. His children will be blessed. He will have a good church, good teaching, good shepherd, and he will be a contributory member there. He will see the good of Jerusalem and he will get the blessings of Jerusalem. And number four, physically, the Lord will give him good life, a good family, children of children, and also in the ministry. In Tamil is a beautiful expression, generation after generation. Valayadi valayaga. It's a promise to you. It's a prophecy to you. The ministry shall continue. My dear brother, my dear sister, and finally, the fifth blessing. Yea, yes, it's true. Thou shalt see peace upon Israel, that land, that nation, the people. The Lord will give you a good family, good church, and a good surrounding. There will be peace upon Israel, a national peace. The land shall have peace. You will be a light unto the land. Your church, your neighborhood, your work spot, wherever you are. If Joseph is in Potiphar's house, that shall be blessed. If he is in prison, that shall be blessed. Because of Joseph, Pharaoh's house will be blessed. Because of Joseph, Egypt will be blessed. Because of Joseph, his brethren shall be blessed. Because of Joseph, the whole world can be blessed. The whole world can be blessed. You shall see the peace of the people around you. The peace of the people around you shall live in peace. It's not that peace is in you. You shall live in peace. Thus shall you be blessed. Thus shall you be blessed. This is how the Lord shall bless thee. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion. My dear brother, my dear sister, God willing, I'll speak to you coming Sunday. 5 points What is meant by fearing the Lord? And 5 points, what is walking in His ways? Psalm 128 is a very powerful psalm. A totality of blessing for every believer. For every believer. A good family. A good financial setup. A good church with good teachings. A shepherd who can lead you with wisdom and prudence. A good life, living in peace. Living in peace. My dear brother, my dear sister. The Lord gave me this sermon at Sundar's wedding. Because of the brevity of time, probably I could not be very elaborate with them. But today I wanted to cover all the 15 points. But I do believe the Lord will surely bless you. Your family should be blessed. Your church life must be blessed. You must be happy, be content and satisfied. There shall be ups and downs. At times I may hurt you. At times some other believer may hurt you. In our side there is a beautiful saying, ஒரு தொழுவத்து மாடு முட்டிக்கும் சேர்ந்துக்கும். ஒரு தொழுவத்து மாடு முட்டிக்கும் சேர்ந்துக்கும். And the more that you want to help me, the more I will shout at you. Who receives more shouting from me? The willing horse is killed. If at all I say correctly, now among the people who are here, poor Selvam receives the most shouting. He helps me the most. He spends more time with me. It's not because there is a love lacking. Not because of love lacking. I may hurt. My dear brother, my dear sister. For me, God, Word of God, God's calling, holiness unto the Lord, the truth, to make a people ready for the Lord, that's predominant. I don't want to hide anything that is good for you. Virojanamana will one day in America verbal. About that pastor yesterday, another servant of God was telling me, Anna Rumbaludar, the line all I pastor Mudela Church, I don't want that situation to come in my life. The line all I pastor Mudela, Ivanga hurt Ayurvanga, Avanga hurt Ayurvanga. No, I love you all very much. I love to tell you everything that is, I feel it is good. Maybe about dress, maybe about the programs that you want to watch. Maybe about your family life. I hurt you. I know I hurt you. When you wear leggings, I hurt you. When you have a program in such a way, I hurt you. When you people dance in such a way, I may hurt you. Just because I feel that's wrong. I want those are given to me. This is our desire, sister, and I desire this. The children whom God has given to us should stand with us in Zion. நாங்களும் எங்களை கர்த்தர் தந்த பிள்ளைகளும் சீயோனில் அடையாளங்களும் அற்புதங்களுமா நிற்கும். கர்மேல் விசுவாசியா? கர்மேலுக்கு போறீங்களா? கர்மேலுக்கு போறீங்களா? That's our desire. The Lord has given you a good church. You all can talk to me at any time. My dear brother, my dear sister. A good spiritual blessing. A good ministry. You should see your children and the children of your children. And you should live in peace. You shall see the peace in Jerusalem. You shall see peace in your family. Peace in your street. Peace among your relatives. Peace among your relatives. With all humility I tell you. Please bear with me. I am not bragging about myself. If this can be of a help, please accept my foolishness. we live in peace. With all our relatives, we live in peace. We live in peace. There's not one single relative I got to whom I cannot talk. There's no single relative that I don't like. Maybe I don't have time to spend with them. Maybe I don't have time to visit them. But I pray for them. I love them, I know they love me. If at all they hate me, they may find fault with me for one reason. For one reason, that I am not visiting them. That you all got that complaint. My dear brother, my dear sister, live in peace. Live in peace. Among your relatives, in your family, in your locality, that's a blessing of the Lord. Why should you live always in the midst of thorns? Live in peace. God will surely bless you. The Lord shall bless you out of our holy Zion. Thus shall be blessed. Thus shall they be blessed. Every one of you. God will surely bless you. You fear the Lord and walk in His ways. Thus shall you be blessed. Glory be to the Lord's holy name.